चक्षुरुन् मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा गदा मह्यं ददाति स्वापदान्तिकम्। हे कृष्णा कर्ण सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेशा गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुस्ते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिय। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधार शिव साधि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। लेट मी सी इफ आई रिमेम्बर दिस प्रेयर। अजाम लंबितो भुजो कमलायताक्षो संकीर्तने कपितरो कनकावदातो विश्वं भरो द्विज भरो युग धर्म पालो वंदे श्री जगत वंदे श्री डज एनीवन रिमेम्बर वंदे श्री जगत गुरु करुणावतारो। I messed up. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prayer in Chaitanya Bhagavat. This month is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance. And this is Gaurav Nitai in Vrindavan, live darshan. This is happening right now. So beautiful, right? Look at the deities and then all your stress is gone. Okay, welcome. Isopanishad Mantra 8. Today we are going to finish the second part of Isopanishad. I actually wanted all of us to chant 8 mantras together. Okay, maybe before we start mantra 9 next week, or I will share with you the first 8 mantras. So we will chant together. Okay. Let's pay our obeisances to Krishna Balram. Let's pay our obeisances to Shri Radha Govinda before we start. So this is what we have been doing. Second part of Isopanishad, the vision of a Mahabhagavata. Mantra 4 explains, we studied why such people are unable to understand Lord's position. He is beyond material calculation and is thus known only when he reveals himself. 5 continues this discussion, describing that Lord has inconceivable potencies which render him unknowable to those whom he does not favor. Na jayati. Means he moves, but he does not move. Or he walks, he does not walk. Tad dure, tad antarasya sarvasya. He's far away, but he's near. And then he's also inside and also outside. So 3 inconceivable potencies were discovered in Mantra 5. Mantra 6, we discussed 3 levels of devotees. Kanishta, Madhyama, and Uttamadhikari. Describes the vision of one who can see Krishna everywhere, the Mahabhagavata. 7 continues describing the consciousness of Mahabhagavata, which was introduced in Mantra 6. Sorry. And today, describes some qualities, Mantra 8 describes some qualities of the Lord as he is known by the Mahabhagavata, as described in Mantra 6 and 7. Okay, so this is all about Krishna today. It's a little difficult to pronounce, so I wrote word by word meaning as well. Now, what we're going to do is going to be a little different. I will chant once and then I'm going to allow all of you to unmute. But please follow my lead. I say and then you say. Okay? No independent saying. Saha par yagat sukram akayam avranam anashviram shuddham apapavidham kavi manisi paribhu swayambhu Okay, so everyone, all the co-hosts, please. Everyone, you can unmute, but please follow my lead in this particular mantra. Saha. Shuddham, Papavidham, Kavir, Anisi, Paribhu, Payambhur, Okay, thank you very much, everyone. Thank you for the try. It's a little bit disorganized on the online preaching, but temple preaching. Madhuri Mataji, you wanted to chant? Please unmute yourself and you can chant. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Saparyaka shukram kayam agranam. Something is coming in between. Asna viram shuddham apapa vidham. Kavir manishi paribhu swayambhu. Yatha tatyato artham yadadar shashvati bhyasamabhya.
Very nice. Mataji, thank you so much. Yes, Sanskrit scholars, Smita Mataji.
No, not scholar. I'll try, but.
Okay.
Saparyaga chukramakayamam varnam asna virashuddham apavidam. Kavir manishi paribhu swayambhu. Yatha tathatyo arthanyat dadha chitabhyas samabhya.
Okay, thank you, Mataji.
I don't know the reason.
Oh, no worries, Mataji. No worries. Okay, Shilpaja Mataji, and then we will go to the reading.
Saprayaga chukram akayam abranam. Ashnaviram shuddham apapa vidham kavir manisi paribhu swayambhur yathathatyato artham vyadadach chashvatibhya samabhya.
Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Uma Kannan Mataji, please keep your hands raised. I'll give you a chance to read. So whoever wants to read the book, please keep your hands raised. We have people. Saha, that person. Prayagat must know, in fact, Shukram, the omnipotent, Akayam, unembodied, Avranam, without reproach, Ashnaviram, without veins, Shuddham, antiseptic, Apapavidham, prophylactic, Kavihi, omniscient, Manisihi, philosopher, Paribhu, the greatest of all, Swayambhu, self-sufficient, Yathat, just in pursuance of Arthan, desirables, Vrida Yathat, awards, Shashvatibhya, immemorial, Samabhya, time. This is what Krishna is. Krishna is called Uttama Shloki. Why? Because he's described with the choicest of words. Who uses this kind of words to describe anybody? The biggest or the biggest kavis or philosophers fail to describe like this. This is Shastras. Translation by His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Such a person must factually know the greatest of all, the personality of Godhead, who is unembodied, number one. Omniscient, number two. Beyond reproach, number three. Without veins, number four. Pure and uncontaminated, number five. Self-sufficient philosophers, number six. Who has been fulfilling everyone's desires since time immemorial. Number seven. Seven qualities of Krishna are described here. Such a person must factually know the greatest of all, the personality of Godhead, who is unembodied, omniscient, beyond reproach, without veins, pure and uncontaminated, the self-sufficient philosopher who has been fulfilling everyone's desires since time immemorial. Hare Krishna. So qualities of the Lord, we are very fortunate to do this. Supreme Lord is not formless. He doesn't have form like ours, but he has his own transcendental form. Krishna is not an energy. Krishna is a possessor of energy, energetic. Today also I finished one 18 day batch. And one Mataji, we know there is supreme power. What supreme power? We know there is supreme powerful. Okay, Krishna is not formless. He does not have form like ours, but he has his own transcendental form. Conditioned soul has a disease. You know what the disease is? Atmavat manyate jagat. Atmavat manyate jagat means I only see others as I am. Because I don't see God, that means God has no form. Atmavat manyate jagat. See the world as you are. Not as the world is, but or see God as you are, but not as God is. There's a difference. That's the disease of the conditioned soul. Liberated soul does not have that disease. So his form is always transcendental. He is unembodied. Mane, he has no veins. We have physiological structure in the body, right? There is a structure. The heart is placed at this particular place. Liver is here. Kidney is here. This is mechanics, physiologies. Now this structures are placed, now connect them through the wires. The wires are the blood vessels, like veins or arteries. Connect. So this is a mechanic. So what is a doctor? Engineer of the body, right? Oh, like you have mechanical engineer, electrical engineer. This is engineer of the body. That too, highly imperfect. He's unembodied, no veins, which means that there is no difference between his body and soul. Nor is he forced, nor he is forced to accept a body according to laws of nature as we are. Krishna is absolute. Absolute means that his form and his soul has no difference. We have this. We have three layers. We have a soul, which is Sachidanand. Mane, it's spiritual. Then the soul is now covered with a subtle body. The subtle body is made of mind, false ego, and intelligence. And then on top of the subtle body is gross body. Earth, water, fire, air, and ether. But we think that this gross body is all in all. No, there's beyond that gross body is a subtle body, and beyond that subtle body is soul. So we are only functioning at 1/3 level of our existence, and that too not completely. But Krishna does not have these veins and everything. Krishna's body and Krishna's soul is one. Satchidananda Vigraha, one. The Lord is complete whole. This we studied. The Lord is a complete whole. There is no difference between him and his body and mind. They are the same. They are the same. Okay? Complete whole. That is the meaning of the complete whole. Means there is no deficiency. No difference between him and his body and mind. Please try to understand Krishna by hearing about Krishna. Not try to look where is Krishna. You cannot. These eyes are imperfect. We cannot even see our own eyelid. Okay, the Lord is omniscient. Omniscient means all-knowing. Kavi. Kavi means omniscient, and omniscient means one who knows everything. Omnipotent, Shukram. Omnipotent means he's very powerful. He's very potent. You see, when we give a vaccine, we say this vaccine is very potent. It can actually prevent you from having this deadly disease. But like that, Krishna is omnipotent, all powerful. Can transform. He can transform matter into spirit and spirit into matter. He can do anything. None of us have that power. Nobody else. Krishna's form, the Lord's form, is called Archivigraha form in the temple. The Lord's Archivigraha form in the temple is not different from the original form of the Lord. This is his expanded form, which descends on the request of the Acharyas and works exactly in the original way by virtue of Lord Omnipotence. Okay, Krishna can assume matter, can convert matter into spirit and spirit into matter. So if you say that, oh, this form is made of stone or metal or painting or wood or whatnot, but Krishna can convert matter into spirit. When Krishna is invited by the Acharyas in a proper bona fide parampara, he can appear through his matter and then make it a spirit. Those who see this form with their imperfect eyes as material only are Kanishtha Adhikaris. So don't stay at the lowest level. We should be very careful to appreciate the Archivigraha form as the Lord himself. This is Srila Prabhupada establishing, which deity is this? Prabhupada is establishing which deity is this? Yes, who wants to tell me? Which deity is this? Any of the co-admins? No, co-hosts? There are hands raised, so I don't know if they're raised for answering or what, but you can write to me in the chat or the co-host can unmute. All right. This is Sri Sri Radha Landaneshwara. Radha Landaneshwara Prabhupada is establishing. And this is Prabhupada is establishing Archivigraha. Which deity is this? This is Radha Gopi Vallabh in Boston. Okay, Prabhupada is doing deity installation ceremony. In Brahma Samhita, 5th chapter, 1st verse, description of Lord as Sachidananda Vigraha, which means that he is the eternal form, fully representing transcendental existence, knowledge and bliss. And in the same book, in verse 32, Lord can, with each and every part of his body, do the work of other body, of other senses. Angani yasya sakalendriya vritti manti pashyanti panti kalayanti chiram jaganti ananda chinmerasa tujvala vigrahasya govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. So angani yasya sakalendriya vritti manti. He can use any part of his, any senses and can do anything out of it. We can only see with our eyes. Krishna can talk with his eyes. Krishna can eat with his eyes. Krishna can grab an object with his eyes. Krishna can use his ears to put food. So when we offer bhoga to Krishna, people say Krishna doesn't eat. Krishna eats. Krishna does not eat like you. Krishna eats from his eyes. Krishna can eat from his glands. Okay, don't try to be diseased. Yato mat tato fat. Whatever one wants, one can do. Or atma mat manyate jagat. There is no nothing beyond my knowledge. What knowledge? This is knowledge. Shuddham means pure. To confirm that Lord is always pure and uncontaminated, Sri Ishopanishad describes him as Shuddham, pure, antiseptic in all circumstances. In all circumstances. He's often compared to the sun, which extracts moisture from many untouchable places on earth. Yet it remains pure. In fact, it purifies obnoxious things by virtue of its sterilizing power, right? We cannot say that, oh, there is such a big infection. Let's say a person with tuberculosis. Oh, that person with tuberculosis is very infectious. You cannot go near. But a person with tuberculosis can go under the sun or no? Can go, right? Because sun has healing powers. Like that, Krishna is, no matter how much impurity is presented in front of Krishna, it becomes pure. Okay? So Krishna is the most pure, Shuddham. He's the source of all purity everywhere else. Apapaviddham. Apapaviddham means that he can make everything, no sin can touch Krishna. Even if he acts in a way that appears to be sinful, his actions are all good. There is no question of being affected by sin. Yesterday when Mataji asked, Krishna killed Shashupal, so he committed sin. Well, that is called Atmavat Manyate Jagat. I'm saying it for the third time today. But the Lord is Apapaviddham. The sin cannot touch him. He is prophylactic. He can prevent. Prophylaxis means, in medicine we use this term, that we give something so that the person does not get infection. Let's say we put some people in antibiotics every day, a small dose, so that they don't get a urinary tract infection. There are diseases like that. Some of you can relate to what I'm saying. So that you don't get infection. So Krishna is like that. Sin cannot touch him. Sin will become purified. Person who sinful approaches Krishna, sin is gone. He's antiseptic in the sense that even an impure thing can become purified just by touching him. The word prophylactic refers to the power of his association. Okay, so if Krishna is killing Kansa, that doesn't mean that he's committing a sin. No, Kansa is getting purified by Krishna's touch. Krishna is dancing with so many girls. It doesn't mean he's doing something sinful. No, everyone is getting purified. We are sinful. That's why we see it as sin. We are what we see. Manisi and Paribhu are the other terms. Manisi means philosopher. Krishna is self-sufficient philosopher, Manisi, but no one knows him. That Krishna says in 10th chapter Bhagavad Gita also, that he's a source of all the great sages. But for him, no one knows in real. The Lord is also described as Paribhu, the greatest of all. Other living beings as described here are described here as beggars who ask goods from the Lord, and he supplies the things the living entities desire. So this is our position in front of Krishna. If the entities were equal to Lord in potency, that is omniscient and omnipotent, there would be no question of their begging from the Lord, even for so-called liberation. Right? So Krishna gave Bhagavad Gita. We are studying Bhagavad Gita so many months, we still don't understand completely. This is what Krishna spoke. We can take lifetime to understand. But Krishna is such a big philosopher, he can go on talking about shastras. And Krishna showed universal form to Arjuna, omnipotent, omniscient. Yathat athyat. The Lord has been supplying goods to living entities since time immemorial. The word means in pursuance with, indicating that the Lord rewards the living entities just in pursuance of their desires. All our desires are getting fulfilled from Krishna, directly or indirectly. A living entity desires something and the Lord supplies the object of that desire in proportion to the qualification. So man proposes, God disposes. But the disposition is going to be according to my qualification. Okay? It's not that I can get everything that I desire. No. That is why people are scared to go to Krishna, because Krishna has discrimination. He sees what is it that I can handle, and that's what I will get. High court judge example is given by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada says that we may be qualified for something, but if we don't get the mercy, we might not be successful. Like, there are many lawyers who are qualified to become a court judge or high court judge, but only a few make it, right? Like by special connections or special ways. If a man wants to be a high court judge, necessary qualifications are insufficient for one to occupy the post. It must be awarded by some superior authority. So Krishna similarly, the Lord, Lord is ignited by serving the devotees of Lord. Okay, we cannot just say, my business is only with Krishna and I don't care about devotees, but that's not what is going to attract Krishna. Krishna is attracted by our service to the Mahabhagavata. That is why I keep asking you all to hear Srila Prabhupada every day. Don't let the day of your life pass without association of Prabhupada. He can put this potency of devotional service in our heart. Unless we know our constitutional position as servants, we don't know what to ask from Lord, which post to seek, right? Which post to seek, what to do. We don't know. Why we don't know properly? Because we don't know what we are. But if we become a devotee of Krishna, then Krishna will give us all protection. All right, so we can read now. Was it Umakkanan Mataji? Mataji, was it you who I asked? Keep your hand raised. You can unmute yourself.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Okay. Hare Krishna.
Shall I read from the mantra, Mataji?
Yes, Mataji.
Sapariyagat chukram akayam avranam asnaviram shuddham apapavittham kavir manisi paribhu svayam bhur yatha athat yato arthan vyadadhat chashvatibhya samabhya. Translation: such a person must know in fact the greatest of all, who is unembodied, omniscient, beyond reproach, without veins, pure and uncontaminated, the self-sufficient philosopher who is awarding everyone's desire since time immemorial. Mm-hmm. Purport: here is the description of the transcendental and eternal form of the absolute personality of Godhead. The Supreme Lord is not formless. He has his own transcendental form, which is not at all similar to those of the mundane world. The living entities in this world have their forms embodied by the material nature, and they work like any material machines. The physiological and anatomical structure of the body of a living being must have a mechanical construction with veins and so forth in the embodiment. But in the transcendental body of the Lord, there is nothing like veins. It is clearly stated that he is unembodied. That means there is no difference between his body and soul, nor does he accept a body by the law of nature as we do. In the material concept of bodily life, the soul is different from the gross embodiment and subtle mind. The Supreme Lord is apart from any such compartmentalized arrangement. However, there is nothing like a difference of body and mind in the Supreme Lord. He is the complete whole and his mind and body and he himself are all one and the same.
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji.
Very nicely read and very nicely chanted, by the way. So, description of the Supreme Lord and his form. So please, after this class, if you can just be convinced that Krishna is not energy or power, he's energetic and he's powerful. He's a person. He's just not like us. But that doesn't mean that he doesn't have a form. The form is not like us. He doesn't have any veins, any mechanical construction or physiological or anatomical structure. He's spirit. He's absolute. His subtle body and his gross body are one and the same. We cannot perceive this and we cannot stretch our imagination and take it somewhere because we don't have an experience of it in this place. Okay, so just hear and chant and slowly Krishna will reveal himself. Also by doing deity worship with proper vidhi reveals this, that yes, one becomes convinced that yes, Krishna is spirit, Krishna is form. Okay, there is nothing like body or mind in Krishna. He's complete whole. Complete whole means one whole, one saman bhuman, one. His mind and body and he himself are all one and the same. Now, Prabhupada is going to give references from Brahma Samhita and everywhere. So the next in list, Geeta Mataji, please go ahead. And then Leena Bhatt Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
In the Brahma Samhita, there is a similar description of the body of the Supreme Lord. He is described there as the Sachida Ananda Vigraha. This means that he is the eternal form fully representing transcendental existence, knowledge and bliss. The Vedic literature states clearly that he has completely different kind of transcendental body and thus he is sometimes described as formless. This formlessness means that he has no form like ours or that he is devoid of a form which we can perceive. In the Brahma Samhita, it is further said that the Lord can do anything and everything with any one of the parts of his body. It is said that with each and every one of the parts of his body, such as the hand, he can do the work of other senses. This means that the Lord can walk with his hands, he can accept a thing by his legs, he can see by his hands and feet, and he can eat by his eyes. In the Shruti mantras, it is said that he has no hands and no legs like us, but that he has a different type of hand and leg by which he can accept all that we offer him and walk faster than anyone anywhere. These things are confirmed in the mantras of Sri Isopanishad by the use of words like omnipotent.
Thank you, Mataji. Very Hare nice. Krishna. So first we studied that that Krishna has a form. He's not formless. His form is not material. He does not have this anatomical and physiologic mechanical construction. There is no difference between his subtle body and him also. That is, anatomical and physiological construction is of a gross body. But subtle body also, he does not have any difference. So he's one complete whole. And his mind and body and he himself are all one and same. And Prabhupada is giving a reference. That is how we should be preaching and understanding. That reference is from Srimad Brahma Samhita. Fifth chapter, first verse and fifth chapter, 32nd verse. First verse, Sachidananda Vigraha. Who knows the first verse of Brahma Samhita? Does anyone know the first verse of Brahma Samhita?
Ishwara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam.
Amazing. See, Ishwara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. So this Sachit and Ananda Vigraha are described by Brahma over there. That Krishna has a form and his form is Sachidananda. And then he gives another reference that don't think that Krishna's senses are like ours, so limited. And that too so defective. Not only limited, but also defective. But Krishna's eyes can eat. Krishna can walk with his hands. Krishna can talk with his legs. Krishna can do anything with any part of his body. Okay, and these things are also confirmed by this mantra of his Upanishad, by the use of the word called omnipotent. Mane, he's completely powerful. He's quite potent about doing anything that he wants. Okay, we go ahead. Leena Bhatt Mataji, please go ahead. The Lord Shri Vigraha.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
The Lord Shri Vigraha, his worshipable form, which is installed in the temples by authorized acharyas who have realized the Lord in terms of Mantra 7, is also non-different from the original form of the Lord. The original form of the Lord is that of Shri Krishna. Shri Krishna expands himself by an unlimited number of forms like Baladeva, Rama, Narasimha, Varaha, etc. And all of these are one and the same personality of God. Similarly, the Archa Vigraha, which is worshipped in the temples, is also an expanded form of the Lord. By worshipping the Archa Vigraha of the Lord, one can at once approach the Lord, who accepts the service of the devotee by his omnipotent energy without any reproach. The Vigraha of the Lord descends by request of the acharyas, the holy teachers, and works exactly in the original way by his omnipotent energy.
Thank you, Foolish. Mataji. Thank you. Very nice. So, see, the Archa Vigraha, people say, what is the need for temple worship? There is a big need for temple worship. Prabhupada called these temples as hospitals. Who goes to the hospital? Who goes to the hospital? Sick person, right? So that they can get cured from their illness and they can regain their health. So like that, everyone in this world is diseased. Everyone has a disease. What is that disease? Birth, death, old age, and disease. So we have to get cured of this. So where do we go? Prabhupada called his temples as oases in the deserts. One can get immediate relief from so many onslaughts. Actually, I was telling, right, six things happens when one starts chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Even if one is chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra with offenses, but they are chanting, the first thing that happens is Kleshagni. One feels light. One feels relieved. There is a feeling of relief. It's described in second chapter of Nectar of Devotion by Rupa Goswami Prabhupada. Kleshagni is the first thing that happens. Even if someone is chanting with Nama Parad, Krishna gives this. Don't you feel this? When you chant Hare Krishna, don't you feel like relief of your miseries? Don't you feel like light, that this is what I want? Pastor Prabhu is backing me up. Yes. Right? So Archa Vigraha form is a bona fide form. So that everyone is writing to me, yes, 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 because it's Rupa Goswami Prabhupada's prophecy, Kleshagni, first thing. And then we wait for five other things to happen. So Archa Vigraha is a bona fide form. And Prabhupada often gives example of a post office, post box. So when we mail a letter in a bona fide post box, it will reach to its destination, even though I have mailed it to a box near my house, but it will reach far away, another city, right? Why? Because it's bona fide. My letter will reach there. Like that. If I worship Archa Vigraha in a bona fide manner, bona fide Archa Vigraha, my service is reaching to Krishna. So there is a need for temples. There is a need, a hospital for the diseased soul. Okay, Dr. Nirupama Mataji. Yes, Mataji. Foolish people.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Foolish people, Mataji, who have no knowledge of this.
I think you're using a wireless speaker. Maybe you're using a wireless speaker or wireless device. That's when this cracking happens.
It's okay,
so you have
Mataji,
to use
now?
Something like this, like wired. Okay, go ahead, Mataji.
Okay. Foolish people who have no knowledge of these mantras of Sri Aiso Upanishad or of any other Shruti mantras, consider that the Sri Vigraha, who is worshipped by the pure devotees, is made of material elements. To the imperfect eyes of the foolish people or to the Kanishta Adhikaris, this form is considered material. But such people with little knowledge do not know that the Lord, being omnipotent and omniscient, can transform matter into spirit and spirit into matter as he desires. In the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord regrets the fallen conditions of men with little knowledge, who regard the body of the Lord as material because he descends like a man into this world. Such poorly informed persons do not know the omnipotent of the Lord. To the mental speculators, therefore, the Lord does not manifest himself in fullness. He can be appreciated only in proportions to one's surrender to him. And the fallen conditions of the living entities is due entirely to forgetfulness of our relationship with God.
Okay. Thank you, Mataji. Very nicely read. Thank you. And very nice voice, by the way. It was nice. So Krishna is saying it again. Prabhupada is writing again and again that one who is not believing in Vigraha form of the Lord is foolish. Right? What is that verse in 7th chapter? Namam Dushkritano Mudha Prapadyante Naradhama Maya Aprita Gyana Asurim Bhava Mashita. Namam Dushkritano Mudha. Mudha means foolish. Does not surrender. For kind of people who don't surrender. Okay, so one of them is foolish. And who is foolish? Who does not accept this? Why not? Why or what seems to be the reason when someone will reject this? What seems to be the reason? The reason is only Maya Prita Jnana. The real knowledge is stolen by Krishna. By Maya, sorry. And why is it stolen by Maya? What happened? Why did it get stolen? Because originally we are all in eternal relationship with Krishna. Because the desire was to enjoy independent of Krishna. Because I did not like Krishna's supremacy. I wanted to be the supreme. Try. Like I tell every class, my Guru Maharaj says this, we can live here as long as we want to live here. As long as I want, I can live in this place. Do you want to live here? Continue to live here? Okay. Hi, Krishna Saita Mataji. Please go ahead with your work. Fallen condition of men is because of little knowledge. And the fallen condition of the living entity is due entirely to forgetfulness of our relationship with Krishna. It is entirely due to the forgetfulness of our relationship with Krishna. There is no other reason. Krishna does not want us to forget. We want to forget. So Krishna has to create a situation where we will forget. Madhuri Mataji chanted, Kirti Mataji, kya Kirti Mataji and then Dyuti.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
In this mantra, as well as in many others in the Vedas, it is clearly mentioned from time immemorial, the Lord is supplying. The living being first of all desires, and then the Lord supplies the object of desire in proportion to the degree of qualification. If a man wants to be a high court judge, he must not only have acquired the necessary qualifications, but he must also depend upon the disposition of the authority concerned, who can award the title of high court judge. Simple acquisition of the qualifications of a high court judge is not sufficient in order to occupy the post. This must be awarded by some superior authority. Similarly, the Lord awards enjoyment to the living being in proportion to his qualifications. In other words, by the law of karma, those qualifications, however, are not sufficient without the mercy of the Lord.
Okay. Thank you, Mataji. Let's discuss a very important point. Maybe we cannot invite you. We will be discussing 10th Canto Srimad Bhagavatam, 8th chapter, verse 14. When did we decide Madhava's and Achyuta's? When did we decide that? 27th? Saturday, yeah, 27th, 3 p.m. India time. How we can see Krishna's loving hand in every situation of life. How we can see, that's the part of being a tolerance project that my group did. That how one can see Krishna's loving hand in everything. If anything happens to anyone, one of the two things is happening. Either Krishna is allowing it or Krishna is doing it himself. So if I'm not a pure devotee, then it's just Krishna is just allowing it. Okay, they've suffered the consequences of karma or do more karma and do this, whatever. But if I become a pure devotee, then Krishna takes direct control. Direct control. And like Prabhupada's life, Krishna took direct control. Without Krishna's mercy, Krishna Shakti nahi, bina nahi hoi parivartan. Without the mercy of Krishna or the potency of Krishna, no one can actually see any change in themselves. There are people who have been chanting Hare Krishna for so long, but they have not been able to move a little bit. And there are people who have made rapid progress. In this class only I see, since June, some of the devotees, they have like shot up. They're taking class, they're doing, they're chanting and they're like reading, and then they didn't know anything about it. And then there are some devotees, I see that also, who are like slowly, slowly dragging. But what is the difference? What is Krishna partial? Krishna is not partial. Yeah, I am not surrendering. So just by having a qualification, let's analyze our situation. Okay? We all have human form of body. We all are been endowed by Krishna with the intelligence to read and write and speak. Correct? So somebody who understands this, okay, this is all I have to use for Krishna, gets in the flight and flies away to Krishna. Like they are, like they don't waste any more time because it's convinced. So surrender is like 100% or 80% or whatever. But somebody says, okay, I have speaking power, I have intelligence, I have, but then I need to read so many other things too. Where is the time to read the Shastras? I have to read so many other things. Now I have vocal cords to talk, but then there's so many other things to talk about. Where is this chanting Hare Krishna mantra time? So we can analyze ourselves. We must show ourselves mirror time to time that what seems to be the reason that I am not progressing. And analyze and then pray to Krishna, pray to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, I invoke your mercy. Without your mercy, I cannot have this intelligence to even think about going one inch in Krishna consciousness. Okay, so Lord awards enjoyment to living being in proportion to his qualification. In other words, by the law of karma. Those qualifications, however, are not sufficient without the mercy of the Lord. Like Prabhupada gave example of a high court judge. So many lawyers are qualified to become high court judge. They are qualified, but qualification is just not enough. There's got to be some mercy. Somebody other's order, superior to them. Duty. Hare Krishna, you can unmute yourself.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Should I continue, Mataji?
Yeah.
Okay, Mataji. Ordinarily, the living beings does not know what to ask from the Lord or what post to qualify himself for. When the living beings know his constitutional position, however, he asks to be accepted into the transcendental association of the Lord in order to render transcendental loving service unto him. Instead of asking for this, the living being, under the influence of material nature, asks for many other things, and his mentality is described in the Bhagavad Gita as divided or splayed intelligence. Spiritual intelligence is one, but the opposite number is of many varieties. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said that persons who are captivated by the temporary beauties of the external energy forget their real aim of life, which is to go back to Godhead. Forgetting this, one tries to adjust things by various plans and programs, which are compared with the process of chewing already chewed refuse. But the Lord is so kind that he allows the forgetful living being to do so without interfering in his activities. If a living being wants to go to hell, the Lord allows him to do so.
Without interference.
Sorry, Madhuri, without interference. And if he wants to go back to home, back to Godhead, the Lord also helps him to do that.
Thank you. Thank you, Duty. It's a very revolutionary verse, a revolutionary paragraph. Prabhupada is saying that we really don't know what to ask for Krishna from Krishna. Our constitutional position is that we are beggars. We have to ask, right? But we just don't know what to ask. We just ask, give me this, give me that, give me this. And what seems to be the reason that why one person does not know what to ask? Because they don't know who they are. they actually it's a work. It's a work. The biggest work is to know who I am. That is the biggest work that anyone can ever do. So a spiritualist is not inactive. It's not inertia. There's a lot of activity behind discovering that self. And once we discover even a little bit of what I am, then you can't stop. And anything and everything is just an opportunity to discover more and more and more. I have seen devotees that I don't even understand how they are so energetic. You can think of Navanishri Prabhu. I don't understand how he does what he does. I have stopped trying to analyze and understand with my menial brain. Can't. You just can't. We work with Prabhu. Sometimes awake till 3 a.m. working. And then at 5:30, he has this first class, right? 5:30 chanting, and then 5:45 to 6 o'clock is Brahma Samhita. Then 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock is, what is it? Bhagavad Gita 18-day class or advanced course. And then from 8:30 to 9:30 is Bhagavatam class. And then he has to go out. We know the whole schedule. I don't even understand how one can do this. My mind gets boggled. Yesterday only I was talking to one Prabhu about it. And I said, my God, my head goes for a spin when I look at the enthusiasm of the devotees. But we can take their shelter. We can beg them. Can you please teach me how can I ask something like this from Krishna? The transcendental loving devotional service. The only activity that a living entity has is this. Transcendental, to render transcendental loving devotional service to him. Instead of asking for this, the living beings under the influence of material nature ask for many other things. And this mentality is described in Bhagavad Gita as divided or splayed intelligence. What is that verse? Who knows the verse? Yes, my co-host. Who knows this verse? Intelligence is splayed or divided. Which chapter, what verse? Nobody. Nobody. Say 2.41 Vyavasatmika buddhi ekehe kurunandana. Bahushaka hi anantascha. Bahushaka mane multifarious or divided, multi-branched. That is not a spiritual intelligence. Spiritual intelligence is only one, just one. God is one, and the activity is also one, and that is to render devotional service to him. Spiritual intelligence is one, but the opposite number of many varieties. But if I am seeing myself attracted to so many other things other than Krishna, then I must understand that I still have a work to do. And that is the biggest compassion one can show themselves. And that will lead to the happy life, because self-compassion leads to compassion for others. We cannot be compassionate to anyone around us if I'm not compassionate to myself. And what does being compassionate to myself means? If you ask a material person, the answer will be take a break, go for a vacation, go for a yoga retreat, or go for a massage, or go for a mani or pedi, or go take a break. That's you. Be compassionate. Watch a movie, right? But if you ask a spiritualist, self-compassion, know who you are. Where have you come from? Where is your real belonging? Why are we changing so much? So now you have a choice, okay? Which kind of a compassion to self we want to use. That material self-compassion is either for the gross body or subtle body, and spiritual self-compassion is for the soul. If I nurture the soul, my gross and subtle body will automatically be nurtured. You don't have to separate. But the Lord is so kind. So I am desiring Krishna give me a dog body, okay? Ready. Krishna does not interfere. Without interfering in his activities. Krishna does not interfere because Krishna wants 100% surrender with knowledge, not a forced surrender. That is why Krishna does not force. He does not want to force anyone to come to him. But if you come to him, then you come in his inner circle and then you become a Mahatma. Sapna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
I should start from the God is described here. God is described here as Paribhu, the greatest of all. No one is greater than or equal to him. Other living beings are described here as beggars who ask from the Lord. And the Lord supplies their desirables. If other entities were equal to the Lord in potency, or if they were omnipotent or omniscient, there would be no questions of begging from the Lord, even for so-called liberation. The real liberation of the living beings is to go back to Godhead. Otherwise, liberation is liberation as conceived by the impersonalist remains as a myth, and the begging business for sense gratification has to continue eternally, unless the beggar comes to his senses and realizes his constitutional position. The Supreme Lord is self-sufficient. When Lord Krishna appeared on earth 5,000 years ago, he displayed the full manifestation of Godhead by his various activities. In his childhood, he killed many powerful demons, and there was no question of acquiring such power by an extraneous endeavor. He lifted Govardhan Hill without any practice of weightlifting. He danced with the gopis without any social restriction and without any reproach. Although the gopis approached him with feelings of amorous love, the mixing of the gopis and Lord Krishna has been worshipped even by Lord Chaitanya, who has a strict sannyasin and rigid follower of disciplinary regulation. To confirm this, Sri Isopanishad says that he is antiseptic and prophylactic, pure and uncontaminated. He is antiseptic in the sense that even an impure thing in the estimation of the mundane world can become purified just by touching him. The word prophylactic refers to his association and is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. There it is said that a scrupulous devotee may appear in the beginning to be durachara, not well behaved. Yet he is still to be accepted as pure because he is on the right path. That is prophylactic nature of the Lord's association.
Thank you, Sapna. Hi, Krishna. So, another quality of Krishna, self-sufficient. He doesn't need to depend on any job or any qualification or anyone else or Mother Nature to provide him. He's quite self-sufficient. Wonderful Krishna, right? Don't you feel, when I read this, when I speak this, and when I hear Prabhupada about this mantra, the chapter in Krishna book comes to my mind, Wonderful Krishna. In that book, all the boys, when they return home in the evening, after being with Krishna all day, they are telling stories to their mothers. You know how small children tell stories to their mothers? Mama, today this happened, that happened. So because they were with Krishna all day, they tell stories to their mothers. Mama, Krishna is so wonderful. Krishna killed Bakasura today. Krishna killed Agasura. It was a big demon. Krishna split his bee like this. Krishna entered the body and we were all saved. Yay, wonderful Krishna. So everyone is like every night in, this is Vrindavan. Evening, everyone is saying, wonderful Krishna, wonderful Krishna. They don't have TV or news channel on. They're talking about this, wonderful Krishna. And that Vrindavan atmosphere can be made anywhere in the whole world by the mercy of Acharya Prabhupada. What do you have to do for that? Talk about Krishna, hear about Krishna. Bolo Krishna, karo Krishna katha. Bhajo Krishna, bolo Krishna, karo Krishna katha. So talk about Krishna, think about Krishna, and hear about Krishna. And then make your house a Vrindavan. And because you're in constant samadhi, when I leave my body, all I'm thinking is Krishna, I go to Krishna. So this is life. This is not life that go on and on and on and on and try to satisfy the senses, which will never be satisfied. It will never be satisfied. It's like feeding a snake. A snake, if you give milk to a poisonous snake, what happens? The snake becomes very gratitudeful, full of gratitude? No. What happens is its poison increases, venom increases. Like that. The uncontrolled senses are like serpents, poisonous serpents. Go on feeding it, more and more lustful desires will keep on increasing. Go feed it, and I have 10 saris, now I have 20 saris, and my after a few years I have 500 saris. Where did I start? 10 saris. If you were satisfied, then this design came, that design came. Covering, at the end, we need to cover the body properly. Why there is a need for 500? Maintain them. Open a big closet. And then, you have to maintain. Maintenance is a quality of Vishnu, Satya Guna, right? Maintenance of anything is very, very difficult. And it will go on increasing. Go on. I have one car. I become very rich. I have 10 cars. Then I become more rich. I have a helicopter. Then I become more rich. I have an airplane. Then I become more rich. I have 100 cars. Then I become more rich. I have my own garage. Oh my God. Where did I start from? One car. Oh my God. This is not going to end. And what was I supposed to do? And then I die. Then all these cars and planes and things are left behind. So what was I supposed to do anyway? So that is why... meditate on wonderful Krishna and make yourself very, very happy. Who wants to be happy in this room? Please raise your hand. Who wants to be happy? I want to be happy. Raise your hand if you want to be happy, really happy.
Happy, yes, happy only by chanting.
Yes, I'm just seeing who wants to be happy and does not want any, not even one misery in their life. Who wants that kind of a life? Well, still people are lacking in raising their hands. What do I make out? What do I make out for the people who have not raised their hands? That they don't know how to raise? I'm going to unmute you, ask you to unmute and tell me, why are you not raising your hand? Don't you want to be happy? Yes, some people have not raised their hands. Why are you not raising? Okay, my co-host may not be able to raise. I know Vasudevan Prabhu wants to be happy.
Yeah, sure.
So it is our birthright to be happy. It's our birthright. This happiness is my birthright. But am I using it or am I abusing it? Thank you so much. This is the only way to become 100% happy. Other ways are cheating. Don't get cheated. Okay. Okay, last paragraph we will read. Thank you everyone for raising your hands. Some of you did not raise hands, but I don't know why. But you're here, so prophylactic, just keep here, stay here. This association is prophylactic. So even if there is some inabilities, Krishna will take care of all of us. Roja Mataji, please go ahead. The word apapa vidham.
Hare Krishna Mataji. The Lord is apapa vidham. There is, that is, nothing like sin can touch him. Even if he may do something which appears to be sinful, such actions are all good, as there is no question of the Lord's being affected by sin. In all circumstances, he is shuddham, most purified, often compared to the sun. The sun exacts moisture from many untouchable places of the earth and itself remains pure. In fact, it purifies obnoxious things by its sterilizing effect. If the sun is so powerful, although only a material object, we can imagine the purity and strength of the all-powerful Lord.
Thank you, Mataji. So we can only imagine the potency of Krishna's name. My spiritual master does prison preaching. He preaches in the prison. And he wrote two books. And the other day he was giving class and he was saying that people in the prison are not like simple people. They have done, like one person he was saying had done 20 murders. 20 murders. One person. My spiritual master was preaching. And that devotee is now chanting 16 rounds of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and is the most well-behaved. He still has to serve the life sentence. He was saying, I think life sentence is 20 or 25 years, but it's been reduced by a couple of years, but it's still a long time in the prison. So we can say so sinful, huh? 20 murders, but chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, one becomes purified. One has to understand that what was I doing? What was I doing? I wasn't supposed to do all that things. It's a very big level of preaching. They told me to work with ISKCON prison ministry. I just said one, yes, once. And I was like, so what is going to happen? The prisoners are going to mail you letters and you just have to reply to them. You never meet them. You can send them books. And I was like, oh my God. So that means I'll have to share my home address. And if they come out of the prison, then so, but they were saying nothing like that. You can give your work address, but still then. So I'm not even that pure to share my address. I am not doing it at the moment. In future, if I become purified, I might do it. But there are devotees who are doing it. ISKCON prison ministry is a thing. And my Guru Maharaj does it without fear, fearlessness. Okay, so we studied. What did we do today? What did we do? Wonderful, Krishna. Krishna, you're so wonderful. Your qualities are so wonderful. And what qualities we studied about our wonderful Krishna? We studied that Krishna is omnipotent and omniscient. Omnipotent means he's very powerful, and omniscient means he knows everything. Kavi. Everything he knows. What we don't know runs our life. If you really study the diagnosis of anxiety, what is the meaning of anxiety? What we don't know runs our life. What will happen next? What will happen next? What will happen next? But once we get convinced, Krishna knows, I am Krishna's property, like a small child. Have you ever seen a small child worrying? Small child doesn't worry. Mother worries. Father worries. My child has to now eat. My child has to shower. My child has to, you know, change clothes. Because father and mother are worrying, child is not worrying. So like that, a devotee is in the hands of Krishna. So what is my worry? Am I worryless? No, you have a worry. What is it? How can I serve Krishna more and more? How can I use my lifespan, my potencies, my intelligence, whatever Krishna gave me in service to Krishna? And Krishna then think more and more, then how can I make this person more and more Krishna conscious? We all can see where we started from. One quality Prabhupada explains in Krishna consciousness is devotee knows where they start from and where they are right now. I know where I started from, what was I when I came to ISKCON, and what I am right now. There's a long way to go, but still I know that what was I. Okay, so Archavigraha cannot be questioned. And then the reference is from Brahma Samhita 2 verses, Sachidanand Vigraha, and then Anganiyasya Sakilendriya, that 5.32 verse. And Archavigraha, Krishna can convert matter to spirit, spirit to matter. Not difficult for Krishna. So whenever you go to temple next, or you look at the deity in your house, or painting of the deity, or on your phone, just pay your obeisances from the heart, because it is Krishna. Okay, and then who will not understand Krishna is a Kanishtha, who has no faith. Faith is a powerful thing. Why people don't have faith? Because the disease of the conditioned soul that I was telling. Atmavad manyate jagad. Whatever I am is whatever others are. If I don't have it, you don't have it. But Krishna is not like that. Krishna's body is transcendental. It cannot be compared to my mechanical and physiological and anatomical arrangement of the gross body, and then my subtle body of mind, intelligent, false ego, and me as a soul. Three separate things. Oh my God. Krishna is complete whole. Okay. And then we studied that my only duty is to render devotional service to him. And then we studied the words like Paribhu. Paribhu means greatest of all. There is no one greater than him. Everyone is a beggar. Everyone. And we studied Krishna is very self-satisfied. Atmaram. He's self-sufficient. He does not have to depend on anyone. Krishna is apapaviddham. No sin can touch Krishna. Krishna is so powerful that if anything sinful comes in front of Krishna, it immediately becomes pure. See, immediately. I see in hospital nowadays, if a COVID patient is admitted in a room, they go and clean the room with UV light. Some light they clean. Mane, that light is so powerful that even if there was a virus remaining in the room, it's now killed, sterilized. Like that Krishna is. Come in front of Krishna and get rid of all the misgivings of the heart. That is why Krishna is called as Hari. Hari means one who steals all the anarthas from someone's heart. Do you want to get stolen like that? If you want to, then you have to chant Hare Krishna. Shuddha means is pure, purest of pure. He's the source of purity. Okay, there's nothing that can happen to him. Nothing can make him dirty. If somebody is dirty, and I gave example of this prison ministry going on, then it becomes, they become pure. All right? Wonderful Krishna, right? Okay, so let's do these questions. Now, the problem is that we have so many hands raised. So how do we do it? Can you please all lower your hands, whoever's hands are raised? There are not many questions. I'm just going to lower the hands. Please don't mind. So I know who is answering and who is not answering. And my co-host, if you can't raise your hand, then please unmute yourself and answer the question. Okay. So first question, Tell me, explain the meaning of Shuddham and Apapavidham. Yes, raise your hand. And don't worry to be wrong. Don't be fearful to be wrong. Anything that's worth doing is worth doing wrongly or badly or whatever, but it's worth doing. Yes, Sharya Mataji. Shuddham Apapavidham.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Shuddham means pure and uncontaminated. And Apapavidham means that the sin cannot touch Krishna.
Very nice. Amazing. You're so young, huh? Krishna. Thank you. Shilpaja Mataji. Yes, Mataji. Sharya has passed 100 out of 100, but still.
Shuddham means pure. And Apapavidham means the sin cannot touch Krishna, his power of his association.
Very nice. Because thank you. Power. Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Leena Pai Mataji, you want to tell me?
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Shuddham means that the superpower Lord is most purified. And Apapavidham means no sin can touch Krishna.
Yes, very nice, Mataji. Thank you.
Mataji.
Okay, so I'm going to go to the next question because then we'll not have time for question answers. Now, this is a difficult question. How is the Lord unembodied? How is Krishna unembodied? If you don't know the answer, then please lower your hands. If you know the answer, then keep your hand raised. Priyadarshini Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. He has no body as such. He has no veins. So he's actually the spirit soul. So body and soul are non-different in the Lord.
So does he have a form or no form?
He has a form. He has a form. But no veins in the form.
Yes, yeah, so no anatomical or mechanical construction.
No anatomical, differentiations in the body.
Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Very nice. 100 out of 100, okay?
Thank you.
Girija Mataji. Yes, Mataji, your hand is raised.
Yeah, actually he is having a form, but it is not a normal physical form like us. He doesn't have any veins or anything. The mind, body, everything he has. And everything acts. Anything can do anything.
So next time when people ask you, is God an energy or God a person? What will you say?
God is certainly a person.
A supreme person.
A supreme person.
Thank you.
Supreme personality of God.
I am so proud of you. Thank you. Meenakshi Mataji, yes. Is God an energy or God a person?
God is person, Mataji, supreme person, as you said. So his body is Satchitanand body, not body like ours. So he has like spiritual or transcendental body, not made of subtle body, material body, subtle and the soul. So it is all one. Transcendental form. So that's why it is unembodied.
Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Yes, Madri Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Yes.
Krishna's body is Satchidananda and he has a form which is full of knowledge, bliss, and an eternal body. So he's like ours, his mind and subtle body. Gross body are not different. And his whole body is from top to bottom, it's spiritual. So soul. And all his senses are multifunctional. One sense can do the function of other senses.
Very nice. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Yes, Jyoti, God is a person or God is an energy?
God is a person, Mataji. Though he doesn't have a form, he has a form, he is not formless. But the thing is, like, since we are conditioned souls, so we are not always able to see, you know, God with our own eyes. And unembodied as in no veins. He doesn't have any, there's no difference between his body and his mind, you know. And he's Satchidananda Vigra. So, there's a,
very nice.
Without conditioned soul, you know, like, there's a difference in us, like, subtle body, gross body, and mind, soul, but in Krishna, there's no difference. He's a whole. He's a one in whole, and he's Satchitananda Vigra.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much. Very nicely said. All right, so we can take up some questions. Anybody with any questions? Shanta Mataji, you have a question? Okay, no. Mistake. Okay, no worries, Mataji. Girija Mataji, you have a question?
Yes, Mataji. I want actually the mantra which you tell in the starting of the class, if you can share that mantra, Ajnana Timirandasya, if you can share that.
The invocation mantra, Seema Mataji, do we have the document for invocation?
I have the document, Mataji. I'll share it.
Thank you, Mataji. And one more thing, what is this Kleshagni which you are mentioning? The
Klesha matlab hota hai, misery. Kleshagni means getting rid of the misery.
Yes, some separate Lashing. Class you were mentioning, no, Mataji? That's what I wanted to.
Oh, that is on 27th March at 3 p.m. that we are going to discuss with my advanced Bhagavad Gita classes. That 10th canto, 8th chapter, verse 14. Tatya Anukampa Shishumikshamano. How Krishna is either doing one of the two things. How Krishna is in control of everything. Sometimes we get bewildered, right? That how Krishna is not in control. That's why this thing happened to me. But then we can understand that how Krishna is doing everything. Either he's doing it himself or he's allowing it to happen in that particular verse. So I was going to take that.
So can we join the class, Mataji?
Yeah, we'll share the information with you. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Okay. Hare Krishna. Khushbu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Mataji, my doubt is this line, spiritual intelligence is one, but the opposite number is of many varieties. I didn't understand this line.
Yes, PhD scholar. Where is this line? Tell me. I remember that numberies is a spelling mistake, but that's numbers. I wrote there, right? 2.4. This is the one. Spiritual intelligence is one, but the opposite number of many varieties. Mane vyavasatmika buddhi eke hi guru nandana. One who is resolute in the purpose. Resolute. That I just want to become Krishna conscious in this life. So they're resolute determination. Very, very resolute. That is called spiritual intelligence. When Krishna comes in that intelligence and one becomes very resolute in that, that is only one. But bahushakai anantascha, mane multi-branched, there are many varieties. Okay, I want Krishna also, but I want good life also. I want good wife also. I want good bank balance also. I want good children also. I want good jewelry also. I want good sari also. But I want Krishna also. So Bari Sahi branches away, right? So many branches now, it has played out. So many varieties. Why? Because they're not understanding that when you want Krishna, these all things will come automatically. So the opposite number of many varieties is one, spiritual intelligence. Did I make it clear or you're still confused or not happy?
Spiritual intelligence is to do with material desires?
No. But spiritual, expand your question more. Please.
No, Mataji. One's desires and wants are many. So spiritual intelligence is one, but the opposite number is of many varieties means the opposite number here is the material desire.
Correct. Independent of Krishna. Yes.
Okay.
Correct. So what is the definition of a material desire, Khushbu?
Material definition.
Or what is your understanding of a material desire?
The wants. In economics, we learn that human wants are always unlimited. So...
In Bhagavatam, we learn the wants of animals are also unlimited. Yes, Lakshmi Nishtala Mataji, you're trying to say something?
No, Mataji, I was thinking that Hare Krishna Mataji, anything other than having love for Krishna and to satisfy our material needs, that is material, definition of material love, is what I thought.
Very nice. Yes. So I want something other than Krishna. See, Khushbu, let's say there is a lady. Okay, she what is a simple woman want? She wants a good husband. She wants good life. She wants good children. She wants good sari, good jewelry. Right? This is like a simple. This is not like this is okay. This is like we commonly see. But you can study Krishna's vibes or all the vibes. When you read Krishna book, the 10th canto Bhagavatam, there is a description of the palace of all the wives. He has 16,108 wives and all of them had their own house. And the description is given that those houses were made of ornaments. There was no matter used, no cement or brick or wood. And the kind of jewelry that those women wore, they never repeated it ever again. The clothes, they never repeated. So Krishna, you think when we want, and what did they want? What did they want? They just wanted to serve Krishna. But because they wanted to serve Krishna, Krishna automatically knew what to do for them and he just gave it. So if we just want to serve Krishna, Krishna knows what I want. Krishna knows what I really want. And I will get. It's just a matter of time. But I don't have patience. That's why I earn something other than Krishna. Let me earn a lot and buy two sets of gold jewelry. What gold? They never repeated in their life what they wore once. So much you will get. Are you understanding now? That
yes.
The,
yes, Mata.
Any desire which has no Krishna in it is a material desire. But the same desire with Krishna in it is a spiritual desire.
Okay. Okay, Mataji.
Okay.
Understood. Mataji, I have one more doubt.
Yes.
Mataji, in this, sorry if I'm wrong, but Mataji, if I don't understand this part where it's written that it is said that there is with each every one part of his body, such as hand, he can do work for other senses, and that whole paragraph which mentions about he can see by his hands and feet, like being in this body. I mean, if even randomly we read something, we try to, I don't know, sometimes we try to picture it.
Yeah, but you can't picture because you don't have an experience of it. That's right.
Agreed, Mataji. But then does that mean if I don't understand this part, like he can walk with his hands and all, does that make me a sinful person? Or does that mean that I'm not ready to understand Krishna or something?
It just means you have a question which is not answered yet. It doesn't make you anything. I just, you have a question which is not yet answered. So if you have a student and the student, you're a teacher, right? And then the student is not convinced of your answer and is not. So you say, oh, you are a mandbuddhi. You don't have intelligence. Or you just say, just wait a little bit longer and you will understand. What will you say?
Yeah, I'll obviously try to explain. But then I'll say that, okay, I'll see whatever I can do to support or to explain you the concept.
But you won't judge the student, right? You won't demoralize them.
No, that's very wrong.
So like that. It was hard for me too. I can understand that how Archivigraha can be a god himself. But once you start doing deity worship, once you become thick, so if you really want to know, then do it. And then know. That's axiomatic truth. First you hear, and then you do, and then you realize.
Because this is for the first time I'm reading like this, because always like we have seen Krishna as with a murli and a cute looking boy and a handsome looking man, you know, the way we have pictured always. But when we talk about this part, that he can see by his hands and feet and he can eat by his eyes and all, so it's difficult to understand. That's what exactly I'm just trying to say. So
to me, it just means that Krishna is very potent, very powerful. That Krishna Krishna can do anything with anything. Prabhupada actually gives an example about this. If you hear Prabhupada's lecture, he gives an example. He says that, okay, he's talking in the class, I hear that. And he says, one of his disciples, that let's say I ask you, Khushbu, let's say I and you are talking, huh? We are sitting. Khushbu, can you please get me a glass of water? You will get me. Huh? And then you'll say, Khushbu, can you please give me a glass of milk? You will go and get milk. Khushbu, can you please go and get me some food, fruit? Can you cut me a mango? If you have, yes, you will cut and give me. Khushbu, can you go and cook me some chapati and sabji and give me? So you see how much potent you are, how many things you can do like that. Because your spirit, dead body cannot do that. Spirit can do so potent. Huh? There's so many things I'm asking, you're giving. Like that, Krishna's organs are so potent. Eyes, can you please look and eat? Yes, we can do. Eyes, can you look and talk? Yes. Eyes, can you talk, walk? Yes. So just stay. Just chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. I cannot. I'm not a pure devotee that I can convince you in one go. Anyone else has anything to say to her? Madri Mataji, Pujya Vrinda Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji. I feel his sense organs have unlimited potentiality. It is infinite actually. That's why probably he's able to do everything.
Not probably. No probable. He is doing
it. He is doing it. I'm sorry. I correct my sentence. He is doing it. Yeah, the potencies are, you can't even, almost unconceivable. It's beyond our imagination.
Correct. So she actually, correct. She hit the nail actually. Inconceivable. You cannot conceive. That is why it is inconceivable.
Yes, Mataji. Hare Krishna, Mataji. May I add?
Yeah, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Mataji, it is just like till you have tasted the fruit, you cannot know what it is. You have to taste it. Like you were saying, karoge to pata chalega. And I actually, jaise it's saying like, jab tak nahi chant karte the, nahi samajhte the, nahi jante, nahi samajh mein aata. Wo jaise tab tak aise tha, bandar kya jaane adrak ka swad wali baat hai, ya bandar ke haath mein motiyon ki mala. So it's like, I feel to myself it like that, Mataji, because initially, as Khushbu Mataji saying, nahin, aise kaise ho sakta hai, aise kaise ho sakta hai. But now, so many times, nahin, always I feel jo bhi ho raha hai is the best that is happening to me or that can happen to me. That is the kind of feeling now I'm getting, and that is, I think, just the power of chanting and having full faith, Mataji. So, that's what I actually feel. Till you do it, you cannot. Till you have to try it to know it, wali baat. You have to taste it.
Khushbu, we need to get you a Brahmanical initiation, and then you're gonna come to the altar with me, and then I'm gonna ask you after 6 months of doing deity worship. Yes, Khushbu, where are you now? Okay.
Sure.
So, Mataji, one question I had, Mataji.
Yes. Mataji, one second. Vasudevan Prabhu, did you want to add something?
Yeah. For instance, in Vaman Avatara, Krishna was a small boy who asked for alms from Bali. And what he asked was three bits of earth. And, you know, Krishna then takes the form in such a way that with his feet, he could measure the whole earth and the sky and beyond. That is something unimaginable, you know, it's a transcendental thing that does that. And similarly, when he lifts Govardhan, he was a 7-year-old boy. With his one finger, he could lift the whole mountain and use it as an umbrella for all the gopis who wanted shelter from the torrential rain that Indra was pouring down. These are some of the powers, transcendental powers. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Krishna Mataji.
Yes, Pujya Vrinda Mataji. Hare Krishna.
See, when you get a higher taste, you never go for the lower taste. When you have tasted this higher, this thing, Krishna consciousness fully, you'll never go for, all the things are really looks like ordinary. That's what I wanted to say.
Thank you, Mataji. Seema, yes. Yes,
Mataji. What I want to say is, after going through the Bhagavad Gita and listening to so many various stories of Krishna, I think we cannot say that I don't know how Krishna cannot talk through his hands and legs. He can do whatever he wants, you know. That's the reason he is Krishna. So I think first thing is you have to fully believe in him, and that he is the ultimate, the most powerful, and he can do anything he wants. And about idol worship, I think we do it every other day, and even I go to the temple every week and I see the idol. And when we look at the deity, we see that they're so beautiful, they're so well-dressed, they look so, and you keep talking to the God, you have a relationship with them. So that's how, once you start building that, you will never question what Krishna is and what he can do. That's what I wanted to add.
Very nice, Mataji. Khushbu, so I will wait for the day when you and I are doing deity worship in the pujari room and I'm teaching you the mantras, and then I sincerely pray that day comes.
I would look forward for that, Mataji.
Hey, Hare Krishna. Madri Mataji, was there anything?
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Mataji, actually, even I wanted to tell that it's very difficult to think like conceive the spiritual things with material this thing. It's really inconceivable. But what I felt once is like we very minutely have qualities of Krishna, very minutely. So when we smell something, we get a feeling that we are as though we are eating. Even in Puri, when they cook the food, they close the nose, because by smelling also we get that feeling of eating. So the whole food becomes jhuta. So that relation I had was that when we are smelling, we feel that we are eating it. So very minutely we have that qualities. Like with that we can at least perceive a little that how the function of one sense can do the function of the other sense.
Very nice. So, yes.
So even in Puri also, the pandas do like that. They tie the cloth around the nose so that they don't smell it. Because if they smell it, it becomes jhuta, as though we have eaten it. Even by seeing the bhog, it becomes jhuta. So they bring it from the tunnel, from the kitchen to the temple, the sanctum where they offer.
Correct. Thank you, Mataji. Listen, Jagannath Puri, she's giving example. Very nice. Thank you. Haven't you heard Isharo, Isharo, me? What is that song used to? Something like Aankho, Aankho, me. Something, so talking Charo, through eyes. Okay. Priyadarshini, Mataji, please go ahead.
Yes, Mataji. In field embodied and unembodied, Mataji, what has been the specific reference of only veins, Mataji?
Prabhupada is giving an example, like veins. Like, because that's what we can relate to. That's what we can relate that. Okay, you can see veins. Now you cannot see your artery. You cannot see your nerves. What can you see when you look at your arm? Veins.
Yes.
So you see, okay, yeah, my hands have veins, but Krishna will not have a hand like that.
That's superficial. Yes, Mataji.
Yes,
Mataji. Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. Just to make our understanding proper. Jyoti, yes.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Mataji, according to Brahma Samhita, 5.32, as we all know, like Krishna, with his each and every part of his body, he can do the work of other senses. So he is somebody who is omnipotent, omnipresent, and we are not compared to him. We are not even an inch equal to him, because we are conditioned soul and we have our limitations, and we don't know our constitutional position. So as beggars, we ask to Krishna, like, we want this, we want that, but we actually don't know what we really want because of our ignorance. Yes.
So you're just sharing your realization? Very nice.
Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. Smita Mataji, yes, Mataji, what is your question?
I wanted to talk on Khushbu. It is her mental status.
Khushbu has so many supporters, Khushbu? So many supporters. Yes, Mataji, Madri Mataji, whoever has to leave, please feel free to go. Hare Krishna, thank you for coming. Yes, Smita Mataji, support her. Where did she go? Smita Mataji. Oh, she logged out. Okay, Rashmi Rajesh Mataji, you have a question?
Yes, Hare Krishna Mataji. In this verse, it was told that Krishna does not have veins. Does it also mean no other internal body organ, like no stomach, no lungs? It could be like that.
No, because Krishna is not dependent on all those things.
Yeah. Then what is the actual meaning of offering nivedyam to Lord if Lord does not have stomach and does not feel hungry?
Because that's what Mataji, you're hitting the nail. 3-4 times I said in today's class, what is the disease of a conditioned soul? Atmavat manyate jagat. We are locking Krishna up. Krishna can only eat by putting food in the mouth and going to the esophagus, to stomach and intestine, and getting digested. So you're locked Krishna up. But Krishna, why are you locking Krishna up? Krishna can do whatever he wants. He's God. He can rip the stomach out and he can still eat it. We cannot lock Krishna. don't lock God up. Don't make him like a category. That is why he's inconceivable. We cannot conceive. Because our experience is limited, we cannot conceive that God is like that. Hear about him more and more. We said Krishna eats through his eyes. So Krishna eats through his eyes. There's no need for intestine or esophagus or stomach or anything. Okay.
Yeah, Mataji, one more thing is that Archa Vigraha has a lot of, you said that you get a feeling like God exists when you do service in the altar for the Archa Vigraha. So we are not supposed to keep Archa Vigraha at home. I attended Prabhu's class once. He was telling that you need 6 people to do many different service to the Lord, and Archa Vigraha should not be kept at home. So we are asked to just keep a picture of Krishna at home. Will the picture also have the same? Will I get the same effect as how you we serve the Archa Vigraha in the temple if I pray with a picture of Krishna at home?
Yes, Mataji, but we are not supposed to keep Radha Krishna Archa Vigraha at home, because Radha Krishna worship is very strict. If somebody has Radha Krishna, then we have to follow all the regulations. If we are not following, then we are not serving. Then they are ignored. That's a sin or offense. Not sin, offense. But we can keep Gauranitai. Gauranitai don't take any sin or any offense. Okay, so this is
Gauranitai, Mataji?
Gauranga and Nityananda. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. And about your question of Krishna's appearing, I think I discussed in one of the classes that how Krishna can appear in 8 forms. Mataji, I'll give you a reference. There's a reference of in 12th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. So you go to vedavis.io and go to Srimad Bhagavatam. Go to 12th canto. And there's an importance. Actually, a grihastha is supposed to have a vigraha at home. And in this book, in this canto, there is a topic of deity worship, which is that chapter. Parikshit Maharaj passes away, 4 category symptoms degraded. Maybe it was in Puranic literature. I don't see it. One second. Let me see this one. Tell me when you see the book or the thing on deity worship. We are in 11th canto now. Lord's opulence, Lord's Varnashram system, Varnashram Dharma, spiritual explanation, the Vedic path, philosophy, 3 modes, Aila Leela, Gyan Yoga, Bhakti Yoga. In Lord Krishna's instructions on the process of deity worship, chapter 27. Mataji.
10 to 11.
Chapter 27. Here it is mentioned that how important it is to do a deity worship, and Krishna can appear. 3 varieties of Archana, deity worship based on either original Veda, secondary. So everything is explained. And Krishna can appear in any of the 8 substances. The deity form of can be worshipped in any of the 8 substances. Stone, wood, metal, clay, paint, sand drawn on the ground, mind or jewels. Okay, so paint. Same. Okay.
Mataji, what about the clay model, Mataji? I have been presented one, gifted one. Even that has got restrictions, Mataji.
If Radha Krishna. If you invoke the deity with the